It's the NFL's greatest season ever on home video. We've taken the best of the best to bring you NFL football that'll grab your gut and cling to your memory. It's like the greatest to the third power. Three volumes of NFL's greatest ever videos packed in one full-strength gift set. The plays, the players, and the game. This collection, hosted by Steve Sable, offers the greatest catches, throws, tackles, players, performances, and much more. How much greatness can you handle? Team, nice concept, in life and on the field. The ones you stick by. Here are all the moments you most want to remember from the 94 season. 28 NFL teams, 28 NFL team videos, plus two expansion teams. We're all a little nosy. Football's a vocal game. And we don't mean play-by-play commentary. And just what is it that the players are shouting at each other?
Hey, baby! We're gonna be here all day, baby!
Intimidation can be more than physical. Words push their weight around, on and off the field. We've grabbed the choicest sound bites so you can experience football as you've never heard it before. In NFL Turf Talk, the 100 greatest sound bites of the NFL.
Okay. This isn't college. You're not at a homecoming.
I understand.
This is NFL, which stands for not for long when you make them calls. Yeah. I'll be selling groceries. 70.
This is 50 minutes of impact, the pure muscle of the game. Schwarzenegger saving the universe. Hey, you tackle problems every day. It feels good to watch someone else do the impossible for a change. It's NFL's 100 greatest tackles. This is going to be the high point of the season. Nothing comes near it, and you'll want to see it again. Superheroes, Superpowered. Coming in February on video, Super Bowl 30. You know when good just doesn't come near it, and great is only halfway there. We're talking the greatest. Be sure to own the greatest season ever on home video from PolyGram Video and NFL Films.
Dear God, we thank you for the gifts that are shared in this room, for the talents that you gave each and every one of us, and for the will that you gave us to sharpen those talents to where they are today. Now pull us all together so that the power that we all create together as a team is just too much today. Strong enough to beat our opponent, strong enough to whip any odds. Make us play our best football game today. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Fight your ass off and win. These are the kind of wins you love to have. This is what makes it fun.
Play action by Erickson. Bootlegs to his right. Throws the post. Downfield toward Dossie. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Dossie on the post, and Erickson put it right in his hands.
A home opener in Tampa Bay traditionally pairs ferocious football and flawless weather.
Short sleeves and suntan lotion in abundance at the stadium today.
Fans basked in the glow of both the warm September sun and a blistering performance from Craig Erickson, who scorched the Colts for three touchdown passes.
Up the middle, here's the snap. Erickson drops, gets the blitz, gets the track record, throws it downfield, has a receiver, it's caught! It's caught! Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Down at the 48 of the Colts, dropping Erickson. Good protection. Throws it over the middle. He has a receiver in the open. Caught by Jackie Herron. It is a touchdown, Tampa Bay! Touchdown, Tampa Bay! It'll be a play-action bootleg by Erickson. Drops, looks over the middle, throws the pass. Caught! Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Courtney Hawkins!
Erickson's performance against Indianapolis was a prelude to an excellent season, which saw Erickson post a quarterback rating of 82.5, the second best mark in team history. His value in throwing 16 touchdowns versus only 10 interceptions is bettered only by his strong presence as a leader both on and off the field. After breaking the Colts in week two, the Bucs look to do some lion taming in week five.
Try to get that ball up the field as fast as you can and make that one person. We can break one against this team. They're good, but they're not that good.
Pre-game planning proved prophetic as Vernon Turner went on a wild ride that ended in the Buccaneer record book as the first punt return for a touchdown in Tampa Bay history.
He'll field to the 20, comes to the near side, got a block down there. High step into the 25, to the 30, down the sideline, 35, 40, 45, 50. We could see history, 40, 35, 30. He's to the 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown Tampa Bay! Touchdown Tampa Bay! Punt return, history!
Charles Wilson's 35-yard catch and carry topped off a 78-yard Buccaneer drive, giving Tampa Bay an early 17-0 advantage.
It's caught at the back. It wasn't 20, to the 15, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! That's how you come out of a timeout, Dave Logan. You throw a touchdown strike.
All around that ball, now knock it loose, and the next guy is going to be there to pick it up.
Montgomery to punt from his own 15-yard line. Vernon Turner awaits at the Buccaneer 33. Bucs come up the middle. It's blocked! At the 10, to the 5. Brady's got it. Bucs have it. First and goal.
Rookie running back Eric Rett's first career touchdown sealed a victory fueled by the high-octane play of assistant coach George Stewart's special teams. After a promising start, the Buccaneers began a mid-season slump which would continue for six games. Close calls and bad breaks were abundant, as were injuries to several key Buccaneer players. A knee injury prevented wide receiver Lawrence Dawsey from making his first start until week 10. 1993 All-Pro linebacker Hardy Nickerson sustained an ankle injury week 4 against Green Bay on the game's first play, forcing him to sit for three games. But even in the darkness of a six-game losing streak, the Buccaneers were able to see the building blocks of their bright future. Rookie quarterback Trent Dilfer showed glimpses of the potential which made him Tampa Bay's number one draft pick. In 1995, quarterback coach Turk Schonert will help Dilfer harness his superior arm strength and athletic ability. Another product of the Buccaneers' 1994 draft was running back Eric Rett. A Florida native, Rett improved with every snap in 94, until by the end of the year, he held virtually every Tampa Bay record for rookie running backs, including yards gained, becoming only the fourth Buccaneer ever to rush for over 1,000 yards. Rett also tied for third in the NFC with seven rushing touchdowns, and was the NFC Offensive Rookie of the Year. With the help of running backs coach Kippy Brown, Rett figures to enter the top echelon of NFL ball carriers in 95. But pounding out yards on the ground is never an individual effort. Running backs Eric Rett and Vince Workman followed lead blocks by fullback Anthony McDowell, Rudy Harris, and one of the top offensive lines in football. A wall of blockers provided clear running lanes for Buccaneer ball carriers. Eliminating penalties was an important part of offensive line coach Bob Wiley's system.
Come on, man. Put a block on. Everybody legal. Everybody legal.
Left tackle Paul Gruber was again the cornerstone of the offense, allowing only one sack and committing just one penalty in his 16 starts. Rounding out the offensive line were guard Charles McRae, number 70. Center Tony Mayberry, number 61. And Ian Beckles, number 62. A guard capable of providing perfect pass protection or powerful blocks far down the field. Along with tackle Scott Dill, number 76, these men contributed above all consistency, allowing only 2 sacks in the final 6 games, best in the NFL, and starting the final 10 games together, something not seen in Tampa Bay since 1979. The Buccaneer defense ranked 11th in the league versus the pass last year thanks to their ball-hawking, hard-hitting secondary.
Intercepting that ball all around them, knocking them loose. Big turnover day. Now this guy will do it.
Under the tutelage of defensive backs coach Johnny Lynn, cornerbacks Martin Mayhew, number 35, and Charles Dimbry, number 39, gave fits to quarterbacks. Then teamed with safety Thomas Everett, number 22, in doling out hits to opposing players. The indisputable leader of the defense is second-year Buccaneer linebacker Hardy Nickerson. Nickerson tied for the team lead in interceptions. He led the team with 122 tackles despite missing most of 3 games. And he is a team leader as well, his powerful play exceeded only by his passion. Traveling to frigid Minnesota to face the red-hot Vikings in Week 13 hardly seemed an ideal way to turn the season around. In fact, the Buccaneers were heavy underdogs against the playoff-bound Vikings. Safety Tony Covington's 38-yard interception return set up an Eric Rett touchdown, which created momentum for Tampa Bay to dominate most of the game.
In motion goes the receiver, handoff to Rett. Rett's got a touchdown. Touchdown Tampa Bay, Eric Rett off right guard. The old play action rolls to his right, looking downfield, under pressure. Harrison throws, end zone is caught. Touchdown Tampa Bay, Courtney Hawkins.
Warren Moon was unable to spot his receivers, spending most of the afternoon on his back as Tampa Bay recorded a season-high 5 sacks. A last-minute prayer and a 2-point conversion enabled the Vikings to send the game into overtime, where the true character of a team is apparent. The Bucs' offense had done their part, keeping pace with the NFC's number one passing offense. And the Bucs' defense had done theirs, harassing Moon all day. Now the game was in the hands of one of the NFL's finest special team units.
Gilliford awaits, calls for the fair catch. He fumbles the football, diving for it. The Buccaneers have it. No flag, no flag. It's down to the 1-yard line. It's down to the 1-yard line. Houston to kick, a 22-yarder. Here's a good snap, the hold, the spot, the kick, it's airborne. Bucs win in overtime. Bucs win in Minnesota. It's over, 20-17. How about that? How about that? A 13-point underdog in a blizzard in Minnesota wins 20-17. And the guy that could have been the GOAT is the hero.
The win in Minnesota was due in large part to the emergence of the defensive line.
Coming down our throats. Let's go. Coming right down our throats this time.
Members Chidi Ahanotu, Mark Wheeler, Brad Culpepper, Eric Curry, and Santana Dotson finish strongly. And defensive line coaches Ken Clark and Tom Pratt have them poised to destroy the opposition in 1995. Back in the friendly confines of Tampa Stadium, a new sense of optimism was reflected in the eyes of the Buccaneer faithful. The defensive line picked up where it left off in the Minnesota game, registering 3 sacks and holding the Redskins to 10 yards rushing on 12 carries.
DC left. Good job, D. That's the way you play ball. Good job. That's the way to get up in his face.
The offense was led by Eric Rett, who gained an outstanding 104 yards in the first half alone. Two-yard plunge and McDowell's TD catch helped the Buccaneers stay close. And tough defense gave the offense a chance to go ahead with 32 seconds left and Washington leading 21-20.
Play of the game, man. Here's the play of the game.
It's tough, coach. Quarterback sneak.
Erickson on the quarterback sneak. He's got the touchdown. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
The Redskins' last flicker of hope was extinguished by cornerback Mike Magruder.
Balls up!
Yards of offense, the fifth best offensive day in Buccaneer history. That's the second best rushing day for an individual. Ran 192 yards. And defensively, that's the fewest rushing yards ever given up by a Buccaneer defense. However, passing wise,
electricity was in the air as the Buccaneers went for their first 3-game winning streak in 12 years against the Rams, and no one was more energized than wide receiver Charles Wilson. Wilson had the most prolific receiving day in Tampa Stadium history, catching 4 passes for a career-high 176 yards and 2 touchdowns.
The play action by Erickson rolls to his left. Cox the arm, throws it downfield. Receiver is Charles Wilson. Makes the catch to the 30. Wilson cuts it back to the 20. Wilson to the left side to the 15, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Charles Wilson!
Eric Rett chipped in with his 4th 100-yard effort in his last 5 games and a touchdown to give Tampa Bay a 17-7 halftime advantage.
He'll hand off to Rett, running right. Rett to the 5, 3, 2, 1, touchdown, Tampa Bay! score every time. An 8-yard TD gallop for the Buccaneers add to their lead.
After a perfect pass beat the Buccaneers' perfect coverage, the Rams were poised to tie the game late in the fourth quarter.
A lot of noise. Here's the snap. A high one. Chandler. It's blocked! It's blocked! Caught in the air by Lynch to the 30, to the 35, to the 40, to the 45. He's out of bounds at the 50.
Los Angeles expected the Bucs to blow out the candles, but no celebration is complete without a little icing on the cake.
Charles Wilson catches it. 10-5. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Oh, Charles Wilson! He's having a career day!
Tampa Bay had won 3 in a row and would go for 4 in another matchup against the Redskins, hoping to achieve their first 4-game winning streak since 1979. At RFK Stadium, wide receiver Lawrence Dawsey put to rest any doubts about his comeback from a knee injury, snaring 7 catches for a career-high 116 yards. Eric Rett continued his domination of the Redskins to give the Buccaneers a 10-7 lead.
7-3 score. Bucs trying to take the lead for the first time. Here's the snap. Hand off to Rett. Runs to the right. Rett with a stiff arm. To the corner. 3-2-1. Touchdown, Tampa Bay!
Special teams once again came through with a clutch punt return.
Here's the kick by Roby. And again, a dandy. Waiting for it. Vernon Turner of the 36. Turner comes to the right side. There's a wall. 40. He's to the 50. He's to the 45, to the 40. He gets by Roby to the 30. He's to the 27-yard line.
Another 6 from Rett was all it took to secure the Buccaneers' 4th straight victory.
They got to get a yard, a long yard, and it's tough inside the 5. Here's the snap. Rett runs up the middle. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. It's a touchdown, Tampa Bay.
On July 29, 1995, Canton, Ohio welcomes the first Buccaneer ever inducted into the Hall of Fame, defensive end Leroy Selman. Selman is Tampa Bay's all-time sack leader and was the catalyst of the Buccaneers' 79 and 81 playoff teams. Respected as a player, Selman is also revered as a humanitarian. But Tampa Bay not only celebrates its proud past, but its bright future. And a major part of that future is the guidance and optimism of new owner Malcolm Glazer.
Well, all my life, I've always had a goal. That's to do a little better each year. And I would hold that same goal for the Bucs, that they'll do better, and everybody in Tampa Bay will be proud of them.
Glazer oversaw an inspired offseason, which saw Tampa Bay among the most active teams pursuing free agents, strengthening weaknesses, and making already sound positions like wide receiver more dangerous. Assistant coach David Culley's receiving corps was a large part of the Buccaneers' strong finish. Number 80, Lawrence Dawsey, led the team in receiving with 46 catches for 673 yards, even though injury forced him to sit for the first 6 games. Number 81, Jackie Harris, pulled in 26 catches, 3 for touchdowns. He was second in receiving among NFC tight ends until a shoulder injury prematurely ended his season. Number 88, Horace Copeland, and number 85, Courtney Hawkins, stood out, with Hawkins' 5 touchdowns tying for the team lead in scoring grabs.
Looking, looking, goes toward the end zone. It's caught! Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Courtney Hawkins!
Charles Wilson's average of 21 yards per catch was 2nd in the NFL. Next year, the Buccaneers will be joined by the man who was first. Wide receiver Alvin Harper comes to Tampa Bay on the heels of his best season ever. In 1994, Harper averaged almost 25 yards per catch, hauling in 33 receptions for a career-high 821 yards and 8 touchdowns. Next year, look for Harper's output to increase dramatically as the team looks for him to be the go-to pass catcher for the Buccaneers. Tampa Bay signed several other free agents, including two Pro Bowlers, punter Reggie Roby and return man Clarence Verdan. Also aiding Sam Wyche next year will be assistant coaches Mike Mularkey, Maxie Baughn, and Brad Roll, with Rusty Tillman taking over as defensive coordinator. Truly, this is the dawn of a new day in Tampa Bay.